back to Movie Studio Zen. My name's Derek. In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to burn a simple DVD or Blu-ray disc that has no menus directly from the Vegas Pro timeline. So when you use this method, you don't have to be worrying about DVD Architect Pro at all. It's all done within Vegas Pro. So let's get started. First thing I'm going to do is drop in a test video file, because this is just a tutorial. And change out the thumbnails. This picture will do. Okay, so the first really important step I'd like you to do is to go into Project Video Properties and press the Match Media Video Settings button. Then navigate back through your computer and select the exact same video file you just imported. Okay, so what that's going to do is match the properties for that video identical to the properties for the entire project. And the reason why this is a good method is that it'll definitely improve the playback quality in the preview window while you're editing. Okay, now while we're in here, make sure we set the full resolution rendering quality to best. Go to the audio tab and change the resample and stretch quality to best as well. Then apply, okay. Then you're going to spend quite some time doing your project. I'm not going to do that for this tutorial. Before I burn it, I'm just going to do a final save as. So in Vegas Pro, remember, we've got to create our own folder structures. Movie Studio users will be used to, Movie Studio has got an advantage because it helps you automatically create folders for your projects. But in Vegas Pro, we've got to do it ourselves. So I'm going to find my Vegas Pro master folder. And okay, I might do this for today. Let's call this DVDs. And I'll call this project basic DVD-1, that'll do. Control copy, open that up. Control V to paste. Okay, so how do we burn the quick DVD? Go to Tools, Burn Disk, DVD. Now, because we set the project properties by matching it to the media, we shouldn't have to worry about any more settings because Vegas Pro has automatically selected the best template that fits with our original video. Now, remember, DVDs only can store standard definition video. So if you want to do burn HD video to a disc, that's when you need to create a Blu-ray. So that's looking pretty good. So all you got to do is put in a blank DVD into your computer, press OK. It will render the video and audio and then burn the DVD. And that's it. That's the end of the tutorial. Well, end of the tutorial as far as making DVDs goes. I'm not going to go through the rest of the steps because I don't really need to. So if you want to make a Blu-ray disc, you do a similar thing. Go to Tools, Burn Disc, Blu-ray Disc. This time, you've got a few more options. So you can actually render to Sony AVC or MPEG-2. I like to choose MPEG-2 because it's a higher quality bitrate. So I'm going to select that. The video template, that should automatically select the correct one again. But just to be sure, we've got 29.97 and that equates to 60i, which is good. Audio format. Now we've got two options here, a WAV file or a Dolby Digital Pro. I'm going to keep it as a WAV file because that's uncompressed. And let's keep it at 16-bit will do for this. Now, if I had added chapter points for the DVD, I'd tick this, but I don't have any chapter points because I'm going to deselect that. Put in a blank Blu-ray disc, click OK. It'll render the video and the audio, and then burn the Blu-ray disc. And that's the end of the tutorial. So that's how you burn a simple disc if you don't want to be using, don't want to be creating menus and using DVD Architect Pro.